Hello, student. Good morning. How are you today? Are you fine, right? Okay. Well, student, you are fine, right? Okay. Today, student, we are going to talk about simple present in question. Okay. The last week, we talked about the simple present in affirmative and negative state. Okay. Well, now, when you have to create a question in simple present, student, it's necessary to know that you have to use the auxiliary do and does. Okay? Repeat after me. Do, does. Okay, student. Now, when do you have to use the auxiliary do? You have to use the auxiliary do when you have as a subject I, you, they, and we. Okay? For example, do you do your homework? In the afternoon? Okay, in the afternoon. Pay attention. Look at this. Do you do your homework in the afternoon? ¿Tú haces tu tarea en las tardes? Another question. With the auxiliary does. When do you have to use the auxiliary does? You have to use the auxiliary does when you have as a subject she, he, and it. Okay? When you have as a subject the personal pronoun that are the third person, okay? ¿Cuándo usamos el does? Cuando tenemos como sujeto a la tercera persona. For example, does she go to school in the morning? Does she go to school in the morning? ¿Ella va al colegio en las mañanas? Okay, look at this. Well, in the first, in number one, we have the auxiliary do. Okay, in number two, we have the auxiliary do. In number two, we have the auxiliary does. Okay, now pay attention. Look at these examples. Now, tell me, what is the structure according to this example, to this question? What do you have to write first when you have to create a question? The first thing that you have to write is the auxiliary. Do or does? Okay? Pay attention. After the auxiliary, you have to write a subject. Okay, for example, in number one, the subject is you. In number two, the subject is she. After the subject, you have to write a verb. The verb has to be in the simple form. El verbo tiene que ser en su forma básica. For example, go is the verb in number two. In number one, the verb is to. After the verb, you have to write a complement, okay? For example, in number one, the complement is your homework in the afternoon. In number two, the complement is to school in the morning, okay? After the complement, you have to write a question mark, okay, student? Don't forget it, okay? No olvides eso. Escribir el signo de pre. Okay, student. Now, pay attention. What is my grammar according to those questions? For example, pay attention. You have to use the auxiliary does with he, and it. They are the third person, right? Okay. Bueno, Usamos el auxiliar das con los subject que son tercera persona. ¿Cuáles son? She, he, and it. ¿Ok? After that, you have to write the verb. For example, I can write, does she watch? Does she watch TV? In the afternoon. Don't forget to write a question mark. No te olvides de colocar el signo de pregunta. Ok, look at this. Does she watch TV in the afternoon? Ok. But pay attention to the bird student. Ok. The verb is in the base form. Ok. El verbo está en su forma básica. Why? Because when you have the auxiliary does at the beginning of the question, it's not necessary to add to the verb the letter S. Ok. It's not necessary. Ok, student. Because you have the auxiliary here. Ok. Bueno, chicos. ¿Por qué al verbo no se le agregó una S si terminó en una H y está con la tercera persona? Porque ya tenemos al auxiliar al comienzo de la pregunta. Cuando está el auxiliar aquí, ya no es necesario colocar nada al verbo. ¿Ok? Now, with the auxiliary do. We use the auxiliary do with the subject that are not the third person, okay? For example, they, I, you, and we. For example, these subjects are not the third person. Muy bien, usamos el auxiliar do con los sujetos que no son tercera persona, como por ejemplo, they, I, you, and we. Ok, after that, you have to write a verb. For example, do they read a book every day? Don't forget to write a question mark. No te olvides de colocar el signo de pregunta. Do they read a book every day? Do I read a book every day? Do you read a book every day? Do we read a book every day? What is the meaning, student? Do you read a book every day? ¿Tú lees un libro todos los días? Ok. Very good. Okay, student, this lesson is very easy, okay? Try to study, try to practice in your house, look in the video, okay? Well, goodbye, student, that's all for today, thank you very much. Bueno, chicos, eso es todo por hoy, muchísimas gracias, adiós, bye bye, tengan un bonito día.